Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to do a full set on the gorgeous Andrea. We're going to use tips for change because we've been doing a lot of sculpts, so we thought we'd use tips for you tip lovers. And we're going to use a few different techniques, so we'll break it up into a few different parts. So, hope you enjoy. So I'm going to do a full natural beige nail on this one because we're going to do a cat eye effect over the top. It's important to get this structure laid out nice. So we're doing it in two beads. So we've got the majority of the length done. So working sort of in 3/4 of the way down. And then the next bead will flow over what we've just done. So we can have our apex. And they join together seamlessly. So all the nails that don't have this sort of framed edge effect will have the natural beige on. Having this natural beige as a background is really nice to work with, and also it's easier to change up the design when the client comes back for a maintenance fill. So these nails that we've sculpted out, we are going to add some pizzazz. And we're going to use the cat's eye product because I want to show you how we can use that to create some different looks. Right, so we need serious black, and then I'm going to use these two colours from the cat's eye. So you've got Frenemy and Galaxy. Now I can show you. Where's my little thing gone? There we are. I'll show you what they look like when they're actually, because I think it's quite deceiving when you see them like this. But then when they actually have the magnet over the top, this is what they look like. So they look like that, and then they look like that with the magnet, those two there. I could sit and look at that for hours. So that's what we're going to use. We're going to do a design with them, and we're not just going to put it on and magnet it, which does look nice, but we're going to do something a little bit different. So I'll need a little bit of backing paper from the sculpting form. We're going to use it from the bottle. Now I always think, you don't have to, but I think the cat's eyes look better over the top of black. So that's why we need the serious black. So I'm going to do 2 coats of serious black on the nails that we're going to do this design on. That in the lung. Pop me that in. I'm going to pop some of the cat's eyes gel polish onto this backing paper. So I've got a little pool so I can dip into that. So we need gel residue wipe off solution and a little dampen dish. So this is going to be to clean our brush because we've got 2 different colours and I want to clean in between the colours. So I'm going to paint some on here, like a cuticle, in this corner. So we're going to use the magnet to push the pigment. Right, go in the lamp. Right, so I'm going to go into the pinkier colour now. You want to go right next to what you've just done. Right, pop that in quick. Right, so you see you want to move it. See how it goes and then it comes back. See what I mean? So when you have the lines of you, what do you want to do this one? And I'm going to come a little bit wider at the bottom with this one. So we come right to the end of that tip. Right, pop that in quick. See what I mean? You've still got that movement. So we use the side rather than going straight on like this. Well, not straight on, because that's straight on. We normally go over the top like this to create this kind of line, this flow. What we're doing is we're using the side, and as we put the side on, it kind of pushes the particles up, but you still get that movement. So you get this gradient of dark, then you get the color at the top there.
Why does it show better on black then? Like, why is it always used with black?
The contrast between the colour and the black makes it look more effective.
But is it just going clear? Like, is it going sort of transparent?
There's a bit of colour there, so if we do this, can you see how, when we thin this out, mm-hmm. now we have pink. And we just paint it on as if it was... You see, there is colour there.
Mm-hmm.
It just exaggerates it.
Again, because why do you want black then?
Because always. The black exaggerates it. I don't know why you don't. I don't know why you don't understand me.
I thought it looked better on that white there.
It just all goes, don't you? If we do the same again, do you see it move? And then in the lamp. And you could do this with, you know, loads of colours, but obviously we've got a theme of colour going through this set. And it's important to go right next to the previous section. You could do any kind of shape. Pop that one in. Can you see how it moves? Let's get some top coat on it. So we're going to use the Urban Graffiti top coat. You're not going to use, where are we? The gel top coat. You're best using the Urban Graffiti top coat because it has got some kind of flex in it. If you use the gel top coat over this, then you will definitely get some kind of chipping. It'll crack and chip. Pop me that in the lamp. Right, so let's start with a little tadpole shape. Pop that in. I'm gonna go in that little gap and go around with the galaxy colour. Pop me that in. So if I was to do a stencil rose, I'm using exactly the same kind of shapes that I would if I was doing a stencil rose. And the magnet is going at the same angle every time. Pop that in the lamp. Actually, it's not going to go at the same angle every time at all. Just told you a lie. Because we're going to come around here now. And come on this side. And you need to be quick, Andrea.
Mm-hmm.
In the lamp. Thank you. Right, ready? Go. I'm gonna come up here and we're gonna keep going round and round until we fill the nail. So we've got enough room for just one last pink section at the bottom. I'm going to top coat it. Let's top coat it and then we'll have a good look at it. I am going to do two top coats on this one just to smooth it out a little bit more. Pop me that in. Right, so what we're going to do now is just buff it a little bit. So as I buff this, you can see how it's a little bit lumpy bumpy. Can you see those marks? That's probably because we've used the gel as an art medium. So we just want to soften that a little bit. Don't over buff this. You don't want to lose the colour underneath. Clean it up. And then that's top coat. So, you see, as we move it, oh, isn't that a bit spectacular?
Gorgeous.
Look at that, that is so cool.
Yeah, it gives like a 3D effect, doesn't it?
Yeah, do you want me to do it to you? It's cool, isn't it, that?
Mm.
It's like it's got folds.
Yeah, it looks like you could see underneath.
Yeah, like a proper rose. So obviously this one's a simpler way of doing it, of doing an effect. But then this one is a little bit more complicated. But they both look cool. For my next trick, what I'm going to do is, I need a bit of black. We can still use the paint, not paint, gel polish that we have on here. But I want some black because we're going to make, I don't know what shape you call this.
Call it a line.
Line here, a line here, and then we're going to do a line there to there, and we're going to meet, and then we're going to go round back here to go that. And then we're going to neaten it up and make it more symmetrical. This is the shape that has no name. Pop me that in the lamp. Give us your little finger. We're going to do one on the little finger as well. Oh, I might do it this way. Oh, yeah. Pop that on the lamp. Alright, so we're going to take some of the Magic Eye. So this is Frenemy. Pop that directly over the top of the black.
Did you just call it Magic Eye?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You did, yeah.
Yeah.
Cat's Eye. Oh, can you remember Magic Eye stuff? That was dead good, that was.
Awesome.
Took me ages to figure that out. Well, you stare at it and then it goes 3D. Are you kidding me?
Yeah, I remember. You just stare at it and stare at it, and then all of a sudden a picture would appear in it.
Oh, is that what that was?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I remember that. Well, you see him on Facebook and stuff.
No. I've never done Facebook, wasn't around.
Oh, I don't know that then.
Right, then we're going to put the magnet over. And you're going to go quick in the lamp. Now we're going to use Galaxy on this one. And that looks so cool. We're going to use the builder in a bottle to create a domed effect directly over the top. I'm just going to tease that to the edges with my brush. Turn it upside down. The other way, hand the other way. Sorry, I didn't realise your hand doesn't turn that way. And let that peak and then take that hand out. Then go into the lamp. Gonna do the same with this one as well. Turn it over. Pop me that in. It's like a jewel. Wipe off the sticky layer of that now. Then we're gonna top coat it. Just the stone for now. It doesn't matter if you go slightly onto the nail. Put me that in the lamp. And then what we're going to do is we're going to get acrygel. And we're going to put some around the edge. We'll need gel residue wipe off solution on a brush. And we're going to put some of this around the edge. So we can adhere some micro beads. The micro beads will frame. Might even put a little stone on as well. We're going to do these little bars. We're going to top coat. And just press that in. Make sure everything's in the right place, and then we can pop that in the lamp and cure. And we're going to do the same with this one. Nice. Look at that. Looks like a gemstone, doesn't it? Like a precious stone. Just look how that moves. I feel like I'm on QVC. Look at the sparkle and the movement of that gemstone. So I'm going to do two coats of the black because we're going to use the cat eye, and it always looks best on black. And Adam loves filming things on black. It's his favourite thing to do. Sorry! Was me that in the lamp. Pop me that in, give me another one. Pop that in. Right, time for the blooming gel. We're going to put a coat of blooming gel over the top of the serious black colour. Just a nice thin coat. Then we're going to use the cat's eye colours. Frenemy and Galaxy. I'm going to place them on in a completely random order and let that bloom. And then we're going to put the magnet on. You've got to be quick with this.
Okay.
So take that hand out.
Okay.
What?
That's off my top.
Stop touching yourself.
I didn't even know I had.
We're just going to take off that fluff with some gel residue wipe off solution. Then, same coat of Blooming Gel. And on with the Cat's Eye colours. Let that bloom.
Is this one done now?
Yeah.
Going quick, yeah.
And then add the magnet. And then in the lab. Whoa, look at that. That is freaky.
That looks really good.
Yeah. And a quick design as well. So let's top coat that. Pop that in. Top coat. Put me that in. I love them. Very nice. Now, if they go pink, because yeah, you're just going to have to wipe over with a little bit of acetone, but yeah, they're already pinky purple anyway, aren't they? So hopefully you'll be fine.
They won't, they'll be fine.
Yeah. There you are, guys. Hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram, all the social media shebang. Everything that I've used today will be listed below, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye. Out. Shrug it all about. Pardon me. Just give you that for free. I was going to say hi, everybody. I'm going to say now, so.